Let's have the first example. So here we have the integral of x squared dx. So let us anti-differentiate x squared dx. So in this case, let us apply the rules on how to find the antiderivatives or integrals involving algebraic expressions. So let's have the fourth rule, which involves exponents. So in this case, this can be written as x raised to the power of 2 plus 1 over 2 plus 1 plus c. Okay, if we evaluate this further, so this becomes x raised to the power of 3, kasi 2 plus 1 is 3, over 2 plus 1, which is equal to 3 plus c. Alright, so that is the integral of x squared dx. Okay? So, ayusin lang natin. So, that is the integral of x squared dx. Alright? So, let's have the second example. Sige. On our second example, okay, here we have, let's say we have the integral of x squared plus 6 dx. So, what will we do here? Okay? There is binomial. Okay? Actually, according to the rules that we have on antiderivatives and integrals involving algebraic expression, we can split this into two. So this becomes the integral of x squared dx and then plus the integral of 6 dx. Okay, do not forget to put the dx, ha? Tsaka yung integral symbol or integral sign tsaka yung dx, they are always partners. Okay, so do not forget to put dx if there's an integral sign, or do not forget to put integral sign kapag may dx. Okay, so dx tsaka yung integral sign magka-partner yan. And then what will we do? Remember, according to, what do we call this? According to the third rule, okay? Yung constant dito, yung 6, pwede natin ilabas yun. So this becomes the integral of x squared dx and then plus 6 times the integral of dx. So pwede yun. And then, let us simplify this further. Let us evaluate this further. So this becomes, or let us apply here the laws that we have. So here we have x raised to the power of 2 plus 1 over 2 plus 1 plus c. And then here, let us evaluate this. So this becomes plus 6. Okay? So constant yan. So 6x plus c. So therefore, kapag simplify natin yan, okay? So this becomes x raised to the power of 2 plus 1 over 2 plus 1 and then plus 6x, then plus 2c. Eh, by the way, sir, so pag sinabing 2c, okay lang ba yun? Kasi constant plus constant is equal to 2 constant. Remember, a constant, kahit lagyan mo pa yan ng times 2, is still a constant. Kaya it is preferable na instead of putting 2c, ang nilalagay na lang natin ay understood c. Because constant plus constant is a constant, of course. So therefore, if we simplify this further, so this becomes x cubed over 3 plus 6x plus c. Okay, so that is the integral of x squared plus 6 dx. Okay? So yun yan. Next, let's have the third example. Okay, on the third example, okay, let's say example number 3. Here we have, okay, let's have the integral of 8x to the 4th dx. Okay, 8x to the 4th dx. So kapag in-evaluate natin yan further, so may constant, pwede natin ilabas yung constant because according to rule number 5, pwede naman yun. So this can be written as 8 times the derivative of x to the 4th dx. Pwede yun. Okay? And then let us evaluate this further. So this becomes 8 times. Okay, let us evaluate x to the 4th dx. So let's follow rule number 4. So in this case, so this becomes x to the 4 plus 1 over 4 plus 1 plus c. So in this case, here we have 8. Sulat po na natin yun, no? Let us rewrite this. 8 times. So this becomes 8 times x to the 5th over 5 plus c. So if we simplify this further, or if we evaluate this further, so this becomes 8x to the 5th over 5 plus c. Okay?